Hi guys, it's MicheleMarieDalene. Today we're going to do something to fill the time between election bullshit. And that is, we're going to reassemble the PowerVault PV122T, which originally took apart to work on it and replace, I suspected, was a full bar unit. Then, like when he told me, change the scooter a bit here. She said to me, "Are you really sure the problem is the drive and not the closer?" And I said, "You know what? I don't know." She says, "Well, why don't we reassemble it?" And see if we can make this thing work. Now, let me get my between even this. Okay, so we're gonna need a Torx bit. So, now I do have an electric screw gun. I really don't recommend you use an electric screw gun for this because an electric screw gun could destroy the screw holes. So, I got some screws in here, so let me see what screw it is. Nope, that's too big. It's the next size. Yes. Okay, so it needs a Torx bit. I don't remember the size. I got the small ones here, so let's see what it says. It needs a T10 Torx. Pretty much this is already assembled. I just gotta fix a couple things inside. The, mechanism. So now let me tilt this camera towards us so we can see what I'm doing, okay? Okay. I know, that's hard to see. Okay, so it's good as gonna get. So, alright, so let's take a look at this. The stuff we have to work for on this is underneath. Now, I already took out some of the bits. So, the first thing I'm gonna do is take out the one screw that's still left and you're holding the bottom on. And after that, we gotta fix the top part too. I have the screw bits and the innards in the screw bucket in another flat rate box, which I'm going to get to that one right now. Because I need these parts anyway, because this is the stuff that's going to go back inside. First thing is the screws. All the screws are inside here. Okay. Now, what does the tape drive itself look like? That's right here. And on this model, this here is pretty much the complete machine. Okay. It is a very much like a Commodore 1541 type drive mechanism. That is, the actual drive itself has no smarts on it at all. It's all controlled by this logic port on the bottom, and it's all surface mount. And so to totally truly fix this is going to be a colossal nightmare. There's nothing physically wrong with the board. So let me put this over here. We're not ready to deal with that quite yet. So let's get the next thing I've got to fix inside. Now, the reason we're doing a video here is it just makes sense to do something a little different. Now, this is where that drive goes inside here. Okay? And the part I'm gonna fix, which doesn't necessarily affect operations directly, but it does affect operations because this is part of the feeder. This has got a plastic unibody, and what happened was, as often does, some of these screws, standoffs, snapped off. Not on this side, but okay. But I gotta take these screws out. This is why you don't want to use a power screwdriver, is for getting these out, because always you break something, okay? So you take those out, okay? Now, carefully push this down, and this is the elevator or device that pulls the tape back and forth. You can see the parts that snapped off. So the first thing I gotta do is I gotta get these screws out. Now you might be saying to yourself, is, gee, wouldn't it be just easier just to leave them in there? And yeah, but you know what? You do that, it's not gonna help. I gotta get, because you still gotta fix this anyway. But I could do that, but I definitely gotta glue the first one. So. We're going to loosen the screw, in case you didn't know, it's because when you fix this, if you don't and you glue it, it's going to cause the other part to glue too. And if you ever need to get this thing apart, you'll never be able to get it off, because crazy glue is almost impossible to remove. Okay, even with the best nail polish remover. Okay? And you can see it's got some plastic that's going to be really hard to get this out. Okay. At least, at the very least, you should do is back the screw up if you can. Okay? Okay, it's getting better. So let me just spin this out real fast here. First thing I gotta do is find out where in the hell did this plastic piece go. Like I said, it could have been easy to just glue it straight in there, which I might still do that. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is let me open up the containers just. This is not my favorite material to work with. Okay, and the reason I have to watch to make sure you can see me. Okay. Now, because I have to be able to place this screw into the raceway, I'm gonna gently screw into the top, so I have something to pick and place this unit. Okay, ideally, you want to have it line up like that, okay? So, now, where is it? To be better to do take a break from the election for a little bit, because like I said, I need a break too. Yes, I want my candidate to win, but... seriously? This doesn't have a poker in it. Okay. Ah! I got it. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to carefully put a few jabs. Oh, that's a lot more than a few, but okay. Put the cap back, guys. If I can find it. That is. That's a lot more than a few drops, Michelle. Yes, it is. Okay. Oh. You ever played the game Operation? Yeah. Okay. And no, I don't get any money for removing your screw. It's not like a game at all. I can't. Okay, now. Okay, now it's gonna take a little time for that to set. Okay? And. I think you should have bought model glue. What do you think it would look better? Yeah. Alright, so that's going to take a while to cure. So let's take a look at this mechanism here. What happens when you get this thing that does two things at once? Okay? There's a stepper motor in the bottom here, some logical control circuits. There's actually two motors. And the first thing it does is this part here rides back and forth. And its whole purpose is... Yeah, it comes apart too. So I'm putting it in. Oops. Okay. Okay. So what it does is it rides against these teeth here. Okay. That gear also has a few other mechanisms, and there's, as you can see, there's quite a few connectors underneath this board here. That does a variety of functions. It checks the status of this board and determines if everything is A-okay. So, that is what we do right now. I'm going to let that screw just set a little longer, because once you put the screws in, this is the same thing. I believe it's the same thing with this side here. This one here doesn't have a slot like the other one does. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to loosen the screw. You can see cracked, just like I said before. So. Like I said, the main thing is this board here, this dry board here controls everything. So this here is a SCSI cable. And I love this Marlo wireless. This is so cool. And this is like, I can't believe you need this. This is, make sure I can see it here. yeah, okay, good idea. Let me show you the things loose and I can turn it. Okay, this here is the Mylar cable. Okay, and this here connects to the back of the dry board. And it has two, you can see it has two connectors on both sides of the chassis. Okay, and they go to two 60 half pitch 68 pin bulkhead connectors. This goes to your card reader. This goes to the fan. This goes, this is not a power supply connector. This is. Okay, so I gotta make sure to put all the plugs in the right place. Okay. So, ideally we should wait until tomorrow, but I'm gonna start putting this back together tonight, so. Let's see. Till tomorrow. Oh well. Okay. Maybe it's just good anyway. I mean, it's. You know what? Maybe right now. Let's scoot back in here. Ah! I'm sticking to me. Yeah, I know you will be. Alright. Alright, so let me put this screw back together, since this is not going to be easy to do anyway. Oh, it's sticking to me. Ouch. No, don't drop pieces. I got it. I think. Maybe not. Figures. Okay. Alright, first of all, given the fact that we're gonna end up gluing this anyway, let me just glue this. So, the same thing, a little bit of glue on this side here. Oops. Let's get the part wrong. Okay. By the way, this is not why this thing was broken, but I don't think this helps any. So, oops, we are just in the process of putting things back together. Let's see. Got a good hook that's underneath here. And there's a lift of pegs. Okay. Okay. Put some screws back in here. Ah! Place the screws back in here. I'm going to try to put this thing together before my memory card and my phone runs out. Which is an iPhone, so I can't pop it out, put a bigger card in if it runs out of room. Okay. Okay. Screw. Now, originally, Dell, which bought the drive mechanism from other companies, Dell didn't actually make these drives themselves. These were originally produced by companies like Quantum. The Benchmark series was from a line of drives that Dell bought, okay? So, the, now, let's put the rest of the drive together. So, I'll show you how to do that. Now, I can't really thread it in. I don't think I can. I don't think I can really thread it in from the bottom. Because from what I saw, it looks like it has to go into the top. Okay? And I could hear something rattling around in here. So, I'm going to make sure everything's... I put a few screws in, and I didn't put every screw in, in case you wanted to know. It's because the, in case, of course, it's time to get apart, it's easier to put some screws in. So, alright, so here we have what we call a raceway. The raceway, okay, and you also will notice that there is a foam board that goes in front here. I don't know why exactly it has a foam piece, but I do know this. I used to thought it was important to have one. So, companies don't usually invest money in the things that they don't think they're going to need, so. Let's see it. Okay. Okay, so the most important thing is what it, this does. This is a carrier that is going to make this mechanism transfer tapes. I'm going to put these screws in the container because I am going to be using. I am missing one piece, and I do not know how important it is. I do know that I took it out and I put it aside, knowing there it is. The neck goes right here. Why there's a foam piece, I don't know. Okay, now the next step is this. This, because it was sheer size, it's going to slide in like that. Okay? Now, I have to get the screws in the bottom. Since I got the screws in on the top again, too, I'm going to have to... Okay. This is going to use standard drive screws with a twist. The Phillips bits. Oh, okay. Let's see, there's one thing. So. So, I'm taking the Phillips screwdriver. My screwdriver is magnetized. This, that's exactly what I want. Okay, when... I can tell if it's going in because the driver isn't falling down my hands and it's tightening up, so... So, by the time I'm done putting all these screws in, I'm sure I'm gonna be editing this video down as I go. So, oh. I don't have a lot of guss on the screwdriver, but there's enough that I can usually get a screw in there if I sit it right. When I have a doubt, I can use the other screwdriver, which is was even stronger than the first one. Okay. So let's get the screw in here. And then after we get these screws in, the next thing to do is we are going to, well, at least do the lay right upside up. No. Uh-oh. Slow process taking these screws in. Okay. Big Clive's not the only fast screwer. Okay. And after this, after we get all these screws in, and we can plug in the cable harnesses and make sure this thing is drumming. Yes, it is. Okay. And it didn't go together the way I wanted it to go together. So let's see. For some reason, CashApp the Phillips are used for the drive mechanism, and the Torx are used by Yes. Now, because these are standard drive screws, if I ever ran out of these, I've got drive screws like this. But I took the time to put all the screws into this container so I could get them back out if I need to. So, now, technically at this point, our drive assembly is assembled. Next thing to do is to plug in the cord. Now, let me point out right now a few very important things about these ribbon cables. Okay, they only go in one way. They're all different, but they are all, okay? Okay, and let's see, plugging them in is pretty simple. It's just a matter, basically, they're all matched up. And there's an extra power supply connector for an external peripheral. Probably for those very rare connectors, okay? So here we have a 3-conductor plug. So it goes in here. Okay. Then the card reader goes in here. Then this cord, again, like I told you, these are okay, so this goes in like this. Try to be gentle, don't try to force the connectors. If they don't go in like they're supposed to, they're gonna potentially make diagnosing a problem a real biatch. Okay. Alright, now let me make sure I didn't miss anything. Okay. Fans connected. Barcode readers connected. This cable is connected. Now, at this point, everything on the bottom is done. So we don't really have any more to do. I'm just making sure everything that looks like it's all set. And everything looks pretty A-okay to me. Now, unfortunately, my new cable that we're going to test it with isn't here yet. Okay? So we're not going to be able to test it with the new cable, but we will be able to run the diagnostics and tests with the original cable, which is connected to my Linux machine. And since it messes up on both computers anyway, it definitely is not... You want to try to treat this with care. It's an old machine. And the plastic parts on it, of course, are very brittle, for one thing. So, now, these screws, they're all really the same. They are identical. But, you might say, wouldn't it be faster? I said they're almost identical. There is a few that are different, and I'm going to show you what the ones are. The one that goes into the plastic unibody tray are different. You will notice that, because they are definitely what you would expect for plastic screws, going into plastic. So, okay, these are machine screws, okay? Okay. And these are here. Are the plastic screws that you will put in that plastic bottom part. Don't get them mixed up. They are different. Okay? So, because the machine screws will not grip to the plastic carousel. They actually will strip it and potentially damage it. So, this is definitely not where you want to use an electric screw gun. Okay? You want to take your time and screw it together like this. Get the right screws here. Okay. So we want to put our metal, our plastic screws, which are the only ones that are coarse threaded. The other ones are smooth threaded. So make sure not to get mixed up. They are different. In fact, the coarse threaded screws won't even work properly in... Okay. And there's a lot of them, so... By the way, the DLT-120T oil loader should be here in a couple of days. And no matter what happens with this one, ideally we get it working and everybody's happy, including me and Lumi. And of course, the ability to maintain my tape backup drive with two working idle loaders would be a fantastic asset at all times, but we'll see. So again, use the plastics, use the metal, or use the horse thread screws to go in here in the bottom. Okay. And, just a matter of putting screws in at this point. Filling all the holes with the appropriate screws. And then we have, also got four screws in the center, and we also have an extra screw hole here, which I believe was for the power supply anchor. Okay, so. I bought this, so it was manufacturer refurbished, but I don't know. The broken pieces in the carousel does not surprise me at all. The first thing is you're dealing with plastic that's really old. Okay, this is the reason why you don't want to go crazy with an electric screw gun, because I'm already starting to feel some slippage on that thread. And it always is good to put your screws, as I did, in a container, because if you don't know, or if you get mixed up between threads, or if there's a lot of different screws and you want to make sure you never have a confusion, you could always go ahead and label the screws with the appropriate thread sizes, or put them in that container specific to that, so you know. For example, like if I said that this is a number 10 coarse thread, I could put this in a container that would say number 10 coarse. Okay. Now, one of the questions I don't even know is, how many ass this is? I don't even know if that's even in the right hole. It's in the right hole. It is? Yep. Okay, so I gotta put the screw in here too. Right. Alright, so why don't I do that real quick? Okay. And these screws here, they're not quite going in right. They're a little off, so I'm going to try to take these screws out a little bit. Maybe this one here goes over here. Because, you know, let me know the thing we shifted in the tray. Okay. Just goes in. Last of those kind of screws, anyway. I'm By the way, this one here is got a multi-voltage universal power supply, so it does both American and European voltages, like many pieces of equipment do. So if you need to use this in the UK, just get the appropriate British mains plug and go, set go. Okay, so now let's deal with the top. Okay, so let's get started with how you put these caddies in, because people often ask me how you do that. Well, these are caddies right here, okay? And there's two sides to these, okay? This side here, the skinny side, goes in like this. Now, there's sometimes getting them exactly positioned right is not always easy, but you can see how it goes on like that. Okay, next one, and if you get it wrong, don't panic. You might just have to reposition your caddies. It's a pain in the ass. I've done it enough times. So, okay, I told you, these, okay, that doesn't seem right. Okay, that seems right, okay. Okay, and then this goes, and when you get everything in, okay, you have to visualize how this thing mechanically runs. Okay, you got 7 caddies to put in. If I put in enough that there's enough that the thing might actually try to start. Okay. Okay. There's a finger. Okay. And there's 7 of these. So, this is when things can get ugly. Because I gotta put these carriers in just right. If I put them in wrong, it's not gonna work. Right? I'm gonna just go ahead and do it this way. Okay. Okay. Alright. So let me stick the power cord here. I'm gonna power this up here. Got a couple cords. Some of these are really short. So So I have a lot of stuff plugged in here, and this is one that came with the other tape dry. Okay. This cord's a little shorter. When I power this in, it's gonna start to initialize, but then because I don't have all the carriers, it's gonna abort with an error message. But it's easier to do it that way than try to do it the other way. If you do it wrong, you're gonna break this thing, okay? So I hit power switch. We have this one here. He's banging in the stuff, so. Okay. As I said, you're gonna get an error message at this point, but that's expected, okay? So, what we're trying to do right now is, let me see if we can get this thing finished powering up here. I can hear the SMPU capacitor starting up, the oscillator, and that's as high between when it starts. I never said this is easy. I said this is a pain in the ass. And this is when things get really ugly. Okay, let me explain. These caddies here on the side are one and then there's, I only have five of them. I still got three more to put in. So, now we get into the mechanism start. So we just go ahead and we put these carriers in. Okay, they go in a certain way. You can notice it. Okay. I like to do it this way if I can because it makes it a lot easier. So what I'm doing is I'm in the process of slowly let the machine spin, and then when I get it go in there properly and it doesn't jam up, then I know I've got it right. Okay. This is a micro beater. So. Okay. So far I got two more to go. Okay. 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 Power ahead. Power this up. I gotta go through. It's easier to do it this way than to try to. Yes, I can force the issue if I wanted to turn these screws by hand, but to do that, you have to basically knock them right off your finger anyway, and so I'd rather not do that, because then it's just going to just compound the problem. So far, so good. Okay, let me just do that with my thumb anyway, because this machine's stalled right when I can't get at it. So, let's see if I can do this. Nope. All right, nope. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead. I turned that off on purpose so I can get this in. Okay. It's hard to sometimes see it, but there's this little rubber foot. These pegs gotta go into that gear. Alright, now I got all of them in, so let's turn this thing on and let it finish post. Okay, now, what we've done today is we reassembled this thing completely, and now we're going to start with some past post. We're going to start by loading a tape into the drive, see if the load mechanism does what it's supposed to do, and then we'll go ahead and get started with that. Okay, so we're going to, next step, what we're going to do is we're going to load a tape, when it completely passes post here, into the drive. Okay, right now it's scanning the system for tapes. There isn't any yet. We have a tape right here, but it doesn't have any barcode on it, but that's okay, because it'll still work even if it doesn't have barcode. It just won't have any idea what the hell's going on. Okay, so I'm gonna start. I gotta technically do this same test for all 8 spots. But we'll start with the first one. The first slip. Here we're gonna go to commands. I'm gonna hit enter. I'm gonna hit import. I'm gonna hit into slip 1. Okay, and it's lacing properly. That's always important. Gotta make sure it loads the tape. There's no other tape to do, so you can go. Now it's gonna go ahead, and the barcode reader is going to try to rotate tapes around so that the barcode reader will see it. Because there's slots here, and the barcode reader's back in the machine. So you're gonna have to just basically do it that way. Now I'm gonna load that import into the drive. So I go back to commands, hit enter. I'm gonna go load cartridge. Only one tape cartridge anyway. See, it still rotates around. It's just why this machine is so slow at this carousel. It's because it's got to go through every time just to do the most basic thing of loading a tape. It has to rotate. That looks good so far. There we go. Now what you may not be able to see is just load the tape into the drive. And that's it. So now the next thing to do is I gotta go ahead and work on testing all the other 7 slots the same way, and then we gotta go ahead and put the final screws back in, and I can do that after I leave. But I'm gonna put the lid on top of this for the time being, so my kitty cats don't, well, do what cats do. You know what I mean? Yeah. So let me take care of that real quick. I don't have to screw it. Just close it. To do that without damaging anything, you just like that. There we go. And I'm going to make sure I have no stray screws on the floor. Put the lid on the top. For the time being, it looks like it's working. So let me eject the tape now. Let me show you. Now it's ejecting the cartridge. Okay, so that's it for time being. And when I come home, I'm going to work on the rest of this mechanism. And as I said, we'll test everything. And yeah, I gotta go about, brush my hair real quick, and go to the polls. But thought you'd enjoy something a little different than listening to me yell about the vote, right? Well, I hope this thing works with the new SCSI cable, because I think that may have been part of the problem, as Lemmy suggested. But for now, thank you very much for watching this diversion. Now, if you ever need to take one of these apart again, you know how to do it. It's just a matter of taking out a lot of screws and a lot of patience. Okay? See you later. Bye-bye.